The FAA Institute Young Driver Excellence Academy, the full name of it, is a program now existing since 2 years, where we want to foster the talent of young people. We want to make them road safety ambassadors. We want to increase their performance capability, but also make sure that they understood about fair racing, about safe racing, about being an ambassador for road safety.
What we're trying to accomplish with the whole program is to make young, rounded professionals and accelerate them on their career. What we want to see in these guys is their proficiency in being fast, fit and professional, which more so in today's environment than any other time in the history of motorsport are just essential credentials.
So it's about creating drivers who have the underpinning knowledge of what's required to compete at the top. They've got some practical experience of how they can best go about that.
It's not only about the driving, it's vehicle dynamics, it's road safety. It's of course going into the mind and the body. It's nutrition, special training, career management, mental preparation. And we are not trying to teach specific techniques to the young drivers. We are showing them what's out, what's around, and the individual has to find out what's best for him.
That's right, we give them the toolbox. How they choose to use it and which tools they pick up, that's up to them. But we'll coach them and help them in finding the right tool for the right time.
At the beginning of a workshop with the young drivers, we first have to teach them the vehicle dynamics, basic laws of physics, underlying laws of physics, to what a tire, what a car can actually deliver and it can't deliver. And I found out that on high grip racetrack situations, oversteer, understeer sliding happens so fast that it's very difficult to process for the mind and to talk about it. So we invented slippery surface training, not to save tires, in fact to extend the time where a problem happens. So if the car slides, the driver has time to process when it's sliding, how it feels when I go above the slip angle, when the grip is coming back. He sees when he makes an input that he's paying after a mistake for it.
The laws of physics, the laws of car dynamics are exactly the same, but everything's happens much more slowly. So you can actually, you've got much more time to feel what's happening. Any input you make to a car is going to take longer to happen, be more noticeable.
In a normal race car, like you said, everything happens so fast. So everything's slowed down, work on the basics, and then you can go fast in a safe way.
When you're outside of the car, you tell yourself, oh, it's easy because you're going at a very low speeds. But as soon as you hop in the car, you're going at 30 k's maybe top, but you have absolutely no grip at all, so it's really hard.
Because it's so slippery, you can't just go full on power and then it would just spin up and you will spin. So you really have to be really, it's like half a centimeter on the throttle and off, really to balance out the car, and that's what I said, it's really fine tuning.
But they've also got the knowledge to go on to become ambassadors in terms of not just the sporting aspect, but also the best practice and the safety aspects as well.
So it's really great that they're putting a lot of focus on that. It's also something you can't really go to school to learn. You've got to learn it by the hard knocks in life.
And they are role models. They're celebrities, they're role models, they're respected, they're credible. And they're credible for two reasons. One, they're successful. They've shown what dedication and commitment can bring. But they're also credible because they're doing the same thing. They're driving a car. And so they can make a very good case about driving in a controlled environment.
I didn't begin rallying until I was 19, so I had 2 full years of driving on the road without having my rally experience. So I was one of those kids that landed out at 17 years of age, you know, waiting for my license to arrive and then out on the road. And probably being realistic, okay, I didn't take risks, but I didn't have enough respect.
As a racing driver, you have a really great opportunity to be so, like being a good example for young people to really take care on the roads and be smart or clever when they're driving.
It's been so great. I've learned so many things I never think I've been able to learn. It's this privilege being part of this program, being instructed by people such as Alex Burr, the Robert Wright.
If you at home want to get chosen for the FAA Institute Young Driver Program, the only thing to do is to get in touch with your ASN, with your national authority, where you get your racing license from, and you need to be nominated from your national ASN. That's really important. There's no other way into the academy other than via your national ASN. They will know the criteria. You have to be between 17 and 23, at least 1 year of experience in racing or rallying, show some results, be fluent in English, then you pretty much qualify for the criteria. Then your ASN will recommend you, and then you come into a big, very hardcore, tough 3-day selection event. And if you're then still in the lucky 18 ones, you made it into the 1-year program of the Young Driver Academy. But to be fast, you have to be safe, safe on the racetrack, safe with your equipment, and safe on the road. And then the doors are wide open for a great motorsport career.